You know, when we first knew that we are coming here, we wanted to prepare a special thing for this festival. And unfortunately, we didn't have enough time. And we had in mind to do something which would be a little bit funny, some kind of a parody on a medley of songs taken from Fiddler on the Roof, as done by the harmonicas. And we thought of doing it. You'll never make chord there. Yeah. And we thought of something like starting the speech, you know, Fiddler on the Roof sounds a little crazy, doesn't it? You know the speech? That's not a fiddle. That's a harmonica. And we are harmonica players. And this is the story about the little village of Spanatevka. Like fiddlers on the roof, trying to scratch a little tune without breaking your neck. It ain't easy, but they do it. And how do they do it? I'll tell you in one word. Nechiganes. And in the village of Spanatevka, there are many, many types. There's Norm Dobson, the tailor. There's Pete Peterson, the butcher. There's Danny Wilson, the candlestick maker. But the best known of all. And then, we figured, I told my boys, wait a minute. We have the original guy who's playing this medley here with us. So why not surprise him and you and ask him, Jerry, would it do us a great, great honor to come up and stay with us and play Fiddler on the Roof. Ladies and gentlemen, you have your harmonica with you.
All I've got to say, ladies and gentlemen, you know, life is full of surprises, and when I first heard this group, I was absolutely amazed, and they are without a doubt the international world's greatest. They're fantastic.
Well, I'll tell you. I don't know. tradition, everyone in Anatevka knows who he is and what God expects him to do. And that's tradition. For instance, there's Sammy the tailor, Heine the butcher, Solomon the candlestick maker, but the best known of all is Yenta the matchmaker. From the Holy Book, mostly misquotations, but he had a close relationship with God and often carried on conversations like this. Dear God, I know you made many, many poor people, and I realize it's no shame to be poor, but it's no great honor either. So what would have been so terrible if I had a small fortune?